Hello adventure riders from around the world. As you can see behind me, I am already in Zurich in Swiss-Moto International Exhibition 2019. Unfortunately, I came a little bit earlier. Now it's 9 o'clock. They'll open at 10. But at least I'll be one of the first people who is going to visit the halls. I really hope that there will be not so many people around so I can show you the new adventure models for 2019. Stay with me. Nice, huh? What a catcher I am, huh? Good, thank you very much. A final countdown. All right, let's do it, huh? Nice, huh? I love the atmosphere. These guys really know their stuff. They know how to organize the people and how to push the people and how to get them hot, ready to go. Wonderful. All right. Let's do it, guys. I'm not gonna lie to you. The bike I'm interested in is the new Yamaha Tenere 700. So I will go first to this bike and I really hope it is there and we'll make a video around it before the crowd is go there. So guys, I'm very pleased to show you the new Yamaha 700 Tenere. The guy just explained me that this one is with lower seat. I don't know how much exactly. We're gonna check this later. Okay, let me check now. It's 88 centimeters and it's 205 kilograms. So this is what it stayed here. So this is the first closer view from the bike. I really like the dash. Wonderful. Wonderful. Really good job from Yamaha. I love it, man. And suspension, the front fender, of course. The prototype was with carbon. This is just plastic, but anyway, it looks cool. Double front disc, 21-18 wheels. They even installed these crash bars, which are not so stable if you ask me, but anyway, they're here. Auxiliary lights, many of you like it. So these hard cases for me are, you know my opinion, I'm not gonna say anything, but anyway, the bike is on the market, very, very, very good. So I'm gonna make more details. 700cc, parallel twin, you know, this engine is not new, it's already well proofed. The foot pegs got this rubber. Good, so you can remove it. Even if you don't remove it, when you step on it, it will provide a good grip. I don't know how much is the clearance, we're gonna check later. It has some kind of bash plate. Good. Maybe not strong enough. It's very, very, I don't know, it's like 0.5 millimeter. It's not strong enough for serious off-road, but anyway. Radiator protectors, good, so far so good, I love it. Handguards, plastic, but in overall it's good. The seat looks very, very, oh, I have to say, motocross stylish. Let me sit on it. Okay, oh, very well. Okay, very well. Dashboard, very nice, nice handlebar, nice position. Dashboard is very nice, very clean. So far, so good. I love it, guys. Okay, let me show my position like this. So good, cool. I can have a flat feet on the ground. Excellent, excellent. So, I love it, yeah? So more details, as I said guys, handguards, plastic, nice bar weight here, simple buttons, mirrors are good, actually very good visibility. What is this? This is for fog lights. Anything else, simple, okay, power outlet, good. Stock power outlet is a good option, excellent. And it also mount for another one. All right, so far so good. I'm gonna give you the specifications later. I don't know anything about the fuel capacity. I think it was 16 liters, but it's in nothing here. So the rear is nice. Only this hard case is really disturb my view, but anyway, many people love it. So far, so good. My cameraman, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Don't forget to check my YouTube channel. Tomorrow evening I will upload the video for this.
Okay.
See you there, huh?
Bye.
Of course, the stock exhaust is not a Karpovic, what we saw on the prototype. Brembo brakes, I think that's 300 millimeters. I'm gonna check later. ABS version, switchable. Let me check on the dashboard. Okay, so I can't see any buttons now, but I like this finishing here. Looks very cool. Foldable gear shift, very good. Side stand, central stand, good. Let me check the brake pedal. Excellent, foldable brake pedal. Actually, this guy has done it everything I need. I don't think that these crash bars are necessary, but at least they have option to have it. So that's it, guys. This is the lower seat, 88 centimeters. I don't think this seat will survive a lot of riding hours, but this is normal for any stock seat. Suspension is not adjustable. You can make some small changes, but not really. Let me check the shock. Yeah, the same with the shock absorber. Not adjustable, I guess. All right. Okay, we can't do anything about it. All right. Whatever. So guys, enough positives. Let's look now from the little bit critical point of view. I think that Yamaha tried to save some money. If we start with this bolt, I already told you. Look at this, how that is even possible to design bolt like this. So it's not really a good decision. And after that, look at this now, how the edges are, like the quality is really not so visible here. It was brilliant on the prototype, but here it's not the case. And also this plastic looks like used already. Suspension 43 millimeters, okay, not strong enough if you ask me, but maybe this is the best option at the moment. I told you about the seat. I don't think that someone will keep the stock seat. Look at the bolts again, they're sticking here like this. I don't know, but anything else, it's good. I like the model, guys. You know I love Yamaha bikes, and I'm waiting for this model from a long time. So I hope you've got the information you need. The prices, I just spoke with this gentleman here, and he said prices, they expect somewhere around 10,000 euros. Hard to say, no prices until this moment. What more from Yamaha? The new Tracer 900 GT. All right. 215 kilograms. 17-inch front wheel. I would say this bike is more for road use, but it could be just a perfect option for someone. Of course, the new dashboard, this tablet style. Got this nice design. Good. I saw this first time in Ducati, so excellent. All right, guys, so this is the new Tenere 1200. I don't see any major changes with the old 1200. It looks for me the same, maybe it is not. Let me know in the comment sections if there are any differences. Huge dashboard, the same windscreen, everything looks exactly the same for me. So no major changes. The same front. So far nothing new. Tracer 700. You know everything about these bikes. I have done a video reviews on it, so if you want to learn more, go and watch the review. This is the famous Nikon, I think was. Just a minute ago I was standing here talking, and then with my peripheral view I saw how this is coming down, and I just moved. I thought that it's going just down. Hey, how are you?
Fine.
You're good?
Yes.
Look good. Alright guys, done with Yamaha. I'm very pleased. I'm very very pleased that they've got this model to see it. So now I'm gonna see something else. It is the new DR450 rally replica. Hey, let me see this. Beautiful. Let me ask first, is this for sale or just to show? And then I'm gonna record it with more detail. I just spoke with the guys there because I was not sure that is it for sale or just prototype or just show it here as a just a nice background. And they said that you can order this, you can buy it for around 30,000 euros. But what you have to do, you have to go to Yamaha dealer, order it and wait for around 2 months. Because actually what you do, you're paying for the model DR450, wait for about 2 months and they're gonna customize everything for you. So the final price is going to be around 30,000 euros. So this is the bike actually, which the guys from Dakar competed. It looks like a really, really serious machine. I love it, all of these carbon details, excellent, just excellent. The three tanks all together, Krapovic of course, good, perfect. Let's go to see the next competitor, KTM 790. I hope you want to see it, huh? Stay tuned, here we go. The new 790 Adventure R, wow, great design. They change a little bit the windscreen. They kept this double light, good. Very powerful WP suspension. Of course, 2118. Okay, so this is the. This is the tank. And, okay, looks beautiful. I have to confess, guys, I've never been a big fan of KTM, but this 790 looks much better in the term of quality than the Tenere. So you can see the details here. Let me sit on it. Okay. Digital dashboard. The standard instruments. Nice white handlebar, good mirrors, good design, plastic handguards, tablet style. So I guess this is adjustable. I'm not gonna bore about it now. Looks cool. Okay, just to see how I'm sitting, my position, flat feet on the ground, good. All right, thank you very much. So I have to these people just to shut me around. Nice quality seat, and I hope will be comfortable. Luggage rack, wide enough if you want to put a duffel bag on. Stock exhaust, big. Okay, the rear brake is not foldable. The foot pegs are I'll see. All right. Okay. ABS, I guess switchable. Adventure R. Nice. Let me read the specifications. Okay. suspension travel 240 millimeters, seat 88 millimeters, petrol tank 20 liters, 199 kilograms, but it is dry. So if you have 20 liters, it will be around 210 kilograms. It has some kind of protection here. Again, not so hard, but I think will be enough. Radiator protectors. Good. Adjustable suspension. Very good. Looks cool. Alright, at least the gear shift is foldable. Alright guys, my conclusion is that in the terms of build quality, KTM looks much better, and better suspension and everything, it looks much more, how I have to say, ready to race. But I will still prefer to take the Tenere because of the reliability and because I'm a, how I have to say, I really trust Yamaha. I don't want to say anything bad about KTMs, but I don't really want to go around the world on KTM. This is a normal version with, I think, 19 front wheel and bigger windscreen and double level seats. So this is 790 Adventure and this is 790 Adventure R. 21 front inch, higher or bigger suspension travel, and just a small changes. Alright, this is the standard 1290S street version, 19 hard cases, panniers, tablet dashboard. So I'm not gonna go on such a details with these models. The rest of the bikes from KTM, nothing really for my channel. Alright, I cannot miss this Husqvarna. You know, I like this bike, I really like it. It's the most powerful bike on this segment, and it is only 150 kilograms, or something like that. But unfortunately, to convert it to a real adventure bike, travel bike, you will need a lot of modifications. Because it is very, very simple bike. You see, even the dashboard is absolutely simple, only the most important things. But guys, it has so much power and so good suspension. This is just blasting. Look at this, very powerful 48 millimeters. WP suspension. It's just a great machine. But as I said guys, unfortunately, to convert it to a real travel bike, you'll need a nice windscreen, you'll need a bigger petrol tank, you'll need some serious modifications, and at the end the price is going to be too much, because it is not cheap either. Let me see the price, but I think it was something like almost 10,000 or 11,000 euros, something like that. Love it, but no chance. Now guys, for everyone who was patient enough to come to this point of the video, I'll provide a little bonus. So guys, guys, it was a long day for me. I hope that you enjoyed, because I really did. Don't forget to subscribe and see you next time. Ciao.